Yo guys, what's up? Sleepio here. Today I wanted to tell you how to prepare best for World Tier 5. There's a few things that I wanna talk about. I also wanted to show a few things on my actual character. But sadly, on the PTS, they deleted all the characters and just gave us one character with a skill build. So yeah, sadly can't show a few things, but most of the things I can show. So let's get started with the video. So first of all, they revamped the crafting system. So if you go to the crafting bench now, you can upgrade the bench to a score of 500. So everything you craft is gear score 500. As you can see, the requirements right here, they're pretty high for the upgrade. Also, you need to donate some items, I guess. I will quickly do that and just show you. But I mean, it's fine since you only upgraded once. And now all of the items are gear score 500. Not just guns, also the gear. And that is a pretty good change, I gotta say. But there's one thing I want to test, and that's if you can reroll that. I didn't read the patch notes yet, not all of them at least. And yeah, quickly wanted to test that. Let me see. So you actually can reroll. Sadly, I don't have anything to reroll it on the mask, because all my other masks have utility stats. Not a single one has defensive, so I could show. But you can definitely recall now, and the stuff you craft is gear score 500, so that's a pretty good change, as I said. And it also means you should farm materials. If you only have one character, then, well, definitely farm 400 on that character. Just get full materials for everything. Also start deconstructing gear pieces again, so you farm all of those high-end crafting materials. Because the crafting cost is still quite high, and yeah, you're gonna need it. And I added something else that is really, really good, especially for more hardcore players, which is the account shared blueprints. So now you can just buy that upgrade thing and your blueprints are shared across all your characters. And that is pretty damn good, because I didn't plan on farming every blueprint on all my characters. I was just waiting for that change so I can get all the blueprints. Talking about blueprints, they also increased the blueprint cap. As you can see, there's a lot more now. And I already have all of them I had before, so they added new blueprints, I think, because they didn't really remove any. I just, for some reason, don't have all of the blueprints on that test account. I don't know why they didn't add everything on that account. I don't know. I have no clue, but yeah. They increased the blueprint cap, so you can get more blueprints now. I was really hoping that they also increase the material cap, or, I don't know, make it character shared. And if you have four characters, they just the cap just increases by four. So 4 times 400, 1,600 on all the characters. I would have liked something like that, but I think they are not doing that, sadly. Other than that, you should basically grind skill mods. I mean, all the normal mods for your gear. You should just grind those, and also skill mods, especially the ones with damage. Because the damage, like, I don't know, the damage mods are getting buffed. Across all the skills, every damage skill will get a big buff. But not just the damage mods, all the mods are getting a big buff. So just collect everything that could be useful. You know, everything that you might want to play when the update goes live. I mean, if you want some suggestions, then I would definitely save up Firefly mods. Yeah, Firefly. I would also save up Seeker Mind mods and drone mods. Especially drone mods, damage and blast radius for the Bombardier drone. I think that's gonna be really juicy. I will show you in a second what the Bombardier drone with a build for it actually looks like, how much damage it has, and yeah, I will actually do that right now, because that is basically it. That is all you can do really to prepare. Just get your materials to max and start farming those skill mods and gear skill mods, like utility mods. Just get good ones, well, if you get good ones, and save them up and don't destroy them. And yeah, that's basically it. Right, now to the Bombardier drone real quick. As you can see, I actually 3k skill power. They just added skill haste and skill power on all the pieces. And yeah, let me quickly show you that drone, because that's insane. So the Bombardier drone. I will just show you the damage first, because I think that's impressive. So the explosive damage is on 1.2 million nearly. Bomb radius is on over 6 meters. You still have only 4 bombs, but look at the mods, please. So you actually have 400 plus 400% more damage. And what they did with the mods, that the mods are so much stronger than the base values, is a really good change. Because that way you have to invest a lot of skill power to get those mods. If they would have just increased the base damage by a lot and kept the mods or just buffed them a little bit, then it would be way too OP with low skill power builds. That way, they buff the base damage, or the base stats, I think, on all the skills a little bit. As I said in my skill video, sadly that wasn't in the patch notes, but I'm pretty sure they buffed the base values across the board, across all the skills, just don't know by how much. But yeah, I mean, I think it's a really, really good change that they did it that way with the mods, because that actually requires you to run a skill build if you want those insane damage numbers.
However, I also tried a few skills, not a Bombardier drone in particular, but I tried a few other damage skills in PvE when I did the expedition with my friends, just with those skill builds. And I gotta say, even on story mode, they feel pretty underwhelming. It still feels a lot better to just shoot your gun. Sure, you can just go AFK for like 30 seconds, have your striker drone up, and it will do all the work. But I mean, if you wanna just AFK, then why even play the game in the first place? So, I don't know, like those AI control skills, I never really saw a point in them, because, I mean, where's the fun? You just press one button, the drone flies up, kills everything, and you just, I don't know, go AFK. As I said, I don't know, I don't really see the point for PvE there. There's definitely a few skills that are gonna be pretty good for PvE, but for really specific things. For example, the Bombardier drone, I can imagine that this will be pretty good for Buddy and Lucy in the raid. If you have like a few guys with an explosive skill build with those drones, try to burst the dogs with that. I don't know, could imagine some of those niche builds. But I mean, just for general gameplay, general PvE activities, I don't think skill build's gonna be that impressive. I think it's still gonna be better to just use a gun build. But on the other hand, you still have a gun with a skill build, even though it does a lot less damage than an actual gun build. But yeah, you still have a gun, so I mean, maybe for a few people it's gonna be something. For me personally, probably not, or most likely not. But yeah, that's basically my opinion about the skills. Also, I will add a list of skill mods that I would personally look out for. Probably just a screenshot in the description, so yeah, either in the description or in the comments or both. You're gonna see when the video goes live.
There's not much more to say really. I think I mentioned everything that you should do to prepare for the update. If I forgot something major, then please let me know in the comments. But I think that was it really. Not much more to do there. And yeah, if you enjoyed the video, then as always, make sure to drop a like or a dislike and maybe subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye.